In this video, you will learn how to edit an existing macro. Macro code is a written programming language called Visual Basic for Applications, VBA, which is the programming language used by all Microsoft Office apps. Once you know the basics of VBA in one Office program, you can apply much of that of what you learn to create applications for other programs in the Office suite. We have created a macro that sorts 100 records by the sales highest to lowest, and then putting the highest sales in cell E2 and sales rep in cell E3. Currently, the cells in E2 and E3 display bolded in red. We want to change the code to italics to cell font in E2 and E3. Click the Developer tab, click on Visual Basic. The VBA Editor opens up into three windows. The Project Explorer window displays like a tree-like diagram consisting of every open workbook. The Properties window shows the properties associated with the selected object in the Project Explorer window. The Code window contains the VBA code, including the code in every recorded macro. In this session, you will work with the contents of the Code window. In VBA, macros are stored in blocks of code called subprocedures, which have the general syntax. In this video, our subprocedure is called highest sales, open parenthesis, close parenthesis. The green font displays the description of what the macro is executing. The commands are the command run by the procedure. Even without knowing the VBA syntax, you can often interpret what each command does by examining the code used in the command. Here is where the macro is sorted in descending order. Here are where the cells were copied and pasted into cells E2 and E3. Here are where the fonts were changed to bold. Here are where the columns were best fit in aligned center. It is always a good idea to copy and paste the code to Notepad before you start editing the code in case you need to revert back a step or two. We're going to add italics to cells E2 and E3. Place the cursor on the end of the line select.font.bold equals true and hit enter. Type the line select.font.italics equals true. Click save on the toolbar at the top of the VBA window. Close the window by clicking on the red X at the top right of the screen. Now run the macro by clicking the shape that is assigned to the macro. The debugger is telling us we have an error in the code. Open the debugger and check where the error is. The macro does not recognize this line of code. The command should not have an S on the end of italics. Remove the S at the end of italics, click on Save on the toolbar, and close the window by clicking the red X at the top of the screen. In the dialog box, the command will stop the debugger, click OK. Run the macro by clicking the shape that is assigned. Editing the VBA worked. The fonts in cell E2 and E3 are now italicized. You have just learned how to edit a macro with the VBA Editor. To learn more about coding, take CIS 150, Object-Oriented Programming Fundamentals at Scottsdale Community College.